بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Inspire 2015.
One man, what can one man do, my brothers and my sisters? How can one man serve deen? Mus'ab radiallahu anhu, you know, young boy, mudallal, spoilt. Before Islam, he was living in luxury, the best of clothes, the best of perfume. His mom was filthy rich. Whatever he wanted, you know, a'tar fata fi Quraysh, the best perfume in all of Quraysh. If he passed through a road, you know, maybe hours after he passed, people say, oh, Mus'ab passed by here, I can smell his fragrance. So spoiled, so much luxury in this dunya. But then the love of Allah and His Prophet entered his heart. Iman entered his heart. And when Iman entered his heart, straight away ambition came for the hereafter rather than this dunya that is, you know, that's not gonna last. His ambition was converted to the hereafter. How can I reach ranks with Allah? This man, my brothers, waited for his opportunity. Patiently. Now deprived of all his money. Now deprived of all his luxury. When 12 of the Ansar gave bay'ah to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we call them al-nuqaba. When these nuqaba of Ansar, people of Medina, when they met Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Hajj season, yearning, thirsty for deen, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to this young boy, this young man, and said, Ya Mus'ab, you go with them to Medina, the land of hijrah, the land of migration. He sends one man. What's one man going to do with the whole tribe? What's man going to do in a strange land? So Mus'ab radiallahu anhu, one man, my brothers and my sisters, goes to Medina with these 12 new converts to Islam. One of them is As'ad ibn Zurara radiallahu anhu. So As'ad is like his, you know, he's like his guide. What do we do? Where do we start? Imagine you arrive in a town, a city, everyone's non-Muslim. What do you do? Where do you start from? Mus'ab radiallahu anhu chose a position. They sat down in this position and then straight away started calling to Allah. Started the effort of da'wah, the work of da'wah. So the leaders of Ansar heard of the arrival of Mus'ab, a man from Quraysh who was calling to a different religion. One of these main tribes of Aus, you know, the tribe of Aus had sub-tribes. One of these main leaders of Aus was Banu Abdul Ashhal. Amongst them, Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh and Usayd ibn Hudayr, radiyallahu anhum ajma'een. At the time, non-Muslims and leaders of these of Medina, leaders of Ansar. They hear that a man came, so straight away, you know, what are we going to do? Sa'ad and Usayd, they start discussing, what should we do? So Sa'ad says, you go and see what this man is doing. So he grabs his spear, Usayd ibn Hudayr, and goes to kill Mus'ab radiyallahu anhu. He arrives where they're calling to Allah, and he starts threatening them. I will do this and I will do that. Why did you come here? What are you doing? With da'wah, there always has to be trials and tests. Always. So he radiyallahu anhu started, you know, threatening them. So Mus'ab radiyallahu anhu said, why don't you sit down and listen to what I have to say? If you like what I have to say, beautiful. If you don't like what I have to say, I will leave instantly. So Usayd said, good, all right. He stuck his spear on the floor and then he sat down to hear. In a few minutes, Usayd radiyallahu anhu accepted Islam instantly. Look at the influence of Mus'ab. Look at the influence and effect of sacrifice. He started talking. Sometimes we think da'wah is words. Da'wah is not words, my brothers and my sisters. Da'wah has to be backed up. Has to be backed up with sacrifice and dua and connection with Allah. So Mus'ab, a few words, radiallahu anhu, Usayd converted straight away. Now Usayd said, behind me is a man, Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh. If this man accepts Islam, all my tribe will convert to Islam. So Usayd goes back to Sa'ad and says, I didn't succeed, please come and deal with the matter. So Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu comes at the time, also non-Muslim of course, and does the same thing. Mus'ab says the same thing to him. Sit down, relax, see what I have to say. He calls him to Islam, and before you know it, Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu also converts. Then Sa'ad and Usayd, they both go back to the people. They gather all the tribe, and he says, by Allah, I have converted to Islam. I will boycott you all if you do not accept the deen of Allah. So in moments, the whole tribe of Banu Abd al-Ashhal accepts Islam. All in the books of Mus'ab. In 1 year, 12 months, Mus'ab radiyallahu anhu was working in da'wah. Complete sub-tribes of the Ansar accepted Islam, and not one house in Medina, not one house did not have a convert in it. Not one house. Every single house Mus'ab radiyallahu anhu reached. Imagine meeting Allah on Judgment Day and Medina is in your pocket. All Medina, with the work in it, with the da'wah that came from it, with the light that spread to the world from it, you go and pray in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is there. And Mus'ab radiyallahu anhu is accumulating all these rewards. Why radiyallahu anhu, a true man? When the battle of Uhud came, Mus'ab radiyallahu anhu was martyred. So he died shortly, year 3 Hijri. Yani he migrated to Medina, you know, a few years passed away radiyallahu anhu. This champion, this hero that gave his life for deen, when they came to bury him, they did not have a big enough shroud to cover his body. If you cover his head, his feet appear. You cover his feet, his head appears. They asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do we do, ya Rasulullah? He goes, cover his head and put some plants on his feet. This is the state he died in. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Quran to be read until Judgment Day. من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه. Amongst the believers that are true men, not all believers are men. When we say men here, we don't mean male. It can be a male, anyone can be a male. But to be a man, whether male or female, have the qualities of men, of true men, that fulfilled the promise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ. Some of them were martyred. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ. Our others are dying and yearning for the opportunity to give their lives for the sake of Allah. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ. وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. They didn't play around with their religion and change the deal they made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where do we stand now? Where do I stand? What have I done for my deen? What have I done for Islam other than complaining and putting others down, criticizing people? Oh, I'm weak, I can't do anything. How can we change this? Wallahi, you can. Wallahi, we can, my brothers and my sisters. You have no idea. Wallahi, a little effort in our time, with genuine dedication and sincerity, a pure intention, you have no idea how much this damages the fortress of batil and corruption. You have no idea. A word you say sometimes can change someone's life. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من دعا إلى هدى. Anyone who calls to guidance, كان له من الأجر مثل أجور من تبعه لا ينقص ذلك من أجورهم شيئا. Anyone who calls to guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the reward of everyone who follows him, without this decreasing the reward in any sense.